Hey there, Tiffany Thomas here with WealthyTiffany.com, and in today's video, I'm going to talk about where to buy a rental property. And before we dive in, if you're ready for financial freedom, I want you to comment freedom below in the comments and make sure and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Hit that little bell to get notified on when I post new videos. And don't forget to like and share this video. And if you're really ready for financial freedom sooner than later, make sure and click the link below this video in the description and I can help you do that. Okay, so let's talk about where to buy a rental property. There are so many options on where to buy rental properties. So let me talk about a few different reasons why I chose to buy where I bought my rental properties. So the first thing that I took into consideration was whether or not I was going to be managing the property myself or if I was going to get a property manager. And I decided that I wanted to manage the property myself. So I ended up choosing somewhere nearby where I currently lived. So I didn't want a property that was super far away that I would have to travel a long distance to fix something at the property or to find a new renter for the property. And that's one of the reasons why I ended up choosing a property that was close to my current home where I lived at the time. And then the next thing that I took into consideration was what kind of tenants was I looking for? Did I want just anybody living in the property, or did I kind of want better tenants, those that would probably pay on time and not ruin my property? And that's what I wanted. I wanted people that would be better tenants, that would kind of take care of the place a little bit better and hopefully pay on time, so that I wouldn't have to worry about those things. So I wanted to choose a location that was a little bit better, that would attract better renters, and it would also make the place easier to rent. And instead of choosing somewhere a little sketchy, where I didn't want to be going out there and showing the place myself, I wanted to choose somewhere, you know, that was a nicer location and that I could attract nicer renters, so that I wouldn't have to worry about so much maintenance on the place or remodeling the place after and having it be a disaster when they moved out, and just hopefully a little bit better tenants who were able to pay on time most of the time, and I wouldn't have to worry about those things. So that is another thing that I took into consideration when I was looking for a property to purchase as a rental. And another thing I took into consideration was what was nearby the property. Was it nearby the mountains? Was it nearby shopping centers, the freeway? And actually all of those things are included in the location of my rental property, my first rental property. So it was close to the canyons, which is really popular in Utah. A lot of people want to go up the canyons, go camping or skiing, snowboarding, or just hiking. There's lots to do up the canyon. And so I kind of, you know, picked a property that was close to the canyon, but not right at the mouth of the canyon, because it snows a lot more if you're by the mouth of the canyon. But anyway, nearby, very close to the canyons, and then also very close to shopping centers, and then also close to public transportation. So there was a bus stop nearby and a whole bunch of shopping places. You know, there's a Target, a Lowe's, a whole bunch of restaurants, Cafe Rio, and even Walmart was on the other side. And yeah, there was just a lot of shopping centers really close to the property. And then it was also very close to the freeway, just a few minutes away from the freeway. And so that, you know, they could just hop on the freeway and get to wherever they wanted to very quickly. So that was another thing I took into consideration. What was surrounding the property? What was nearby the property? Was it convenient for those that would be living there? And another thing I took into consideration was the age of the property. I didn't want something that was super old that I would have to do a lot of updates on or remodels on, that were going to be just, you know, super huge projects. And I just wanted something, a little bit newer and not brand new, but just in a good condition because I don't do remodeling myself, so I would have to pay for someone else to do that for me. So I kind of looked at locations that had newer buildings, not brand new, but that weren't super old. So I took that into consideration as well. So these are just a few things that I was looking at when I was purchasing my first rental property. And hopefully that gives you an idea on things to look for when you are deciding where to buy a rental property. And you can kind of decide maybe you do want a property that's kind of in a lower income area. They are a lot less expensive, and you don't mind, having high turnover of renters or fixing up the place. Maybe you don't mind that, so that might be your preference. But it's just, something to consider if you want to pay a little bit more for the property so you can get better renters, and you can also charge a higher rent if it's a better property, if it's in a better location and it's a nicer property. So don't forget about that part as well. Yeah, hopefully this kind of just gives you an idea on some things to take into consideration when you're deciding where to buy your rental property. And I want to hear what your ideas are, so please post those below in the comments. I would love to know what else you look for when you are buying a property and you're wondering what location to purchase the property in. So comment below and tell me what your thoughts are, if you agree with these or if you have different ideas. And if you found this video helpful, please like the video and share it with someone else who would need this information. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. And you guys, if you're ready for financial freedom sooner than later, click the link below this video and I can help you get there. Okay, I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you.